What's going on, everybody? We have some big, and I mean big, things in regards to this video about what happens verbatimly in direction of what happens in episode 14 and 15 of Bleach the Thousand Year Blood War Arc. First exclusive here, you heard it here first. We're going to talk about what happens, what's going on throughout these episodes, what we're going to be expecting, and just anything in between. So if you don't want to get spoiled, please click off the video, of course, hit that like first before you leave. But if you're interested to see what happens throughout these episodes, again, come through, enjoy, and let's just get into the nitty-gritty of it, because it seems like it's going to be some interesting stuff with some new and some old things involved. So if you can, hit that like, subscribe, and that bell notification to find out what's going to be going on in these episodes and future episodes going forward. So let's get into it. Let's start off with episode 14. If you haven't seen my last video where we go over the synopsis, it pretty much goes as follows. But at the start of the episode, we're going to get baby Yuha Baha, and he's going to be held by a bunch of Quincy's. Then we pan over to Yuha choosing Uryu as the successor, and might I add as well that there is going to be no dialogue at the start of the episode of Yuha, the baby version, and we're just going to get some really nice, seductive music from Shiro Sagatsu. As per usual, what's to be expected from anything from Shiro Sagatsu other than greatness? So after he chooses Uryu as the successor, Uryu starts contemplating in a scene full of graves. Now again, I don't know the context, I don't know what this looks like, I don't know really, this seems to be new material that wasn't in the manga, so again, I'm excited to see how that's going to be looking out, especially within this full of graves of Quincy's, I imagine, what these graves are. And before I get into this next part of the episode, I want to just say, I told you so. I knew that this was happening. The meme of Rukia's butt's not going to get shown, and we're not going to get Yoruichi's Flash of Thunder, you know, a chapter panel or whatever, right? I mean, the meme goes back all the way into the manga days, but, you know, I'll talk about that when the episode comes in and of itself, when we actually get to view it. But it is confirmed that we are going to be getting the Bambietta seductive scene of where she sees that Quincy, seducts him, he can't do the job, and she slices him in half. Now again, all I know is that obviously Bambietta seduces the guy, and then the next frame we get to see him cut in half. But what I have been told, fellas, is that there is boob in this episode. There is Bambietta boob, so we've won. We've absolutely smashed it, fellas. Which again, I'm going to talk about when the episode drops, because I'll give you the context of how we got to be kind of excited about this moment. So again, click that like and subscribe, and when that review comes out, we'll talk about it. So yes, the Bambietta scene happens. Of course, I would imagine then we do get the introduction of all the Bambi girls. I haven't had a confirmation of this, but I assume that that's what's going to happen. This might not be all in chronological order of the episode. I was just told things in the episode as a whole. But then we get to see Renji and Rukia shown training, and Byaki gets up on his feet, so that's going to be nice. Shuhei then also goes to visit Ichigo's friends, Keigo, Mizuru, Tatsuki, to give them the soul tickets, which are going to be black instead of the blue that you would see in Bleach Brave Souls. So it seems like there has been a color change there, though it wasn't really changed, I don't think it was, within the colored manga of Bleach. So they're sticking to that color of the Soul Pass tickets. So will BBS going to be needing to change those? We'll have to maybe wait and see. BBS update soon. Then again, the blue is fine and they don't really need to, but it'd be funny if they did. The invasion of the Sarutai then seems to begin, where everything comes out of the shadows and takes over and becomes like the new Von Lom Reich, so to say, where it's the Quincy Palace and the Quincy world, so to say. So then that happens with the red sky taking over. And then we have the episode ending with an Ichigo back shot. And of course, going from the summary, it seems that Ichigo wanted to go to the World of the Living or the Soul Society. But of course, Ichigo is like, no, you can't defeat Yuha, blah, 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 blah. And of course, Ichigo goes to probably go for his training. Again, there is an ending point at the end of this video for an extra edition, but I don't know which episode it's going to be in, so I'll just throw that in towards the end. Now we're on to episode 15. I don't know the title of this one. I didn't ask, unfortunately. But again, shout outs to Mr. E for helping me out with this, who was there. He was at the event and he came through clutch and came to tell me everything that he remembered. Again, he did say he did struggle, because apparently in these episodes, it does go back and forth quite a lot, to a point where it almost seems not disorientating, but in terms of trying to remember how everything canonically went, I would imagine for your first time viewing, you probably do get a little bit distracted on where things were placed. But so it does seem to go back and forth on the invasion and then seeing what somebody else is doing. So, as I said, it starts off episode 15 with the Quincy table that we see within the PV. It then cuts back again into the invasion of the Soul Society. And then again, we get to see a bunch of Shinigami get yeeted, killed, massacred, etc., etc. To be honest, at this point, I'm very surprised at the idea that they even have Shinigamis left. Even after post-war, it is a little bit surprising. But I guess souls are always coming through to the Soul Society all the time anyway, right? Because that's how life and death works over there. But still, there's a lot of Shinigamis that like are just dying as pawns. So it's quite funny that they still have some to this day. So yeah, a bunch of Shinigamis are getting absolutely yeeted. This then starts to follow the manga in its course. Because we then get the lab scene where Asken shows up. And then Mayuri comes in with his absolute massive drip. With, of course, our baby girl Nemo. Then it switches to Jugrim and Shunsui, and then to Shiro versus Barsby with Rangiku. Now, there is a little bit of a change here, which is interesting, and I do want to talk about this, is Amida gets attacked by BG9, as we know. And this, of course, changes, because if you are a fan of the manga or read the manga, you would know that Amida's sister does actually get stabbed by BG9. However, in the anime, this changes. Amida's sister doesn't get stabbed. In fact, Amida saves his sister. Now, I believe from the talk show that happened after the event of the pre-screening, it was led to my belief system anyway that what was said at this event is that the animators really wanted to give Amida more of a time to shine. They wanted to give him some sort of redemption or some sort of significance, and I think that they still do. So it's really cool. In that sense, it's interesting that Amida's actually coming through for once. Even as a lieutenant, at least he can do something besides be weak, or in conventional senses, be a bitch, right? So even though we may or may not like Amida, I don't think really anyone does. It's good that his position as a lieutenant can at least show some humanity in the idea that he can do something useful, and that is saving his sister. Yeah, does it get rid of like a shock value? Absolutely, but I'm not against this change. I want to see how it happens, obviously. But on paper, it sounds pretty cool, especially if they want to give Amida a good moment here. I think this might be not redeeming for him, but a moment that's quite nice nonetheless. So shout out to Amida. Good job, buddy. You actually did something useful. Then, of course, Soifan comes in to the rescue, as you would in the manga. But the one thing that's really appreciated here is that Soifan appears fast. And when I say fast, the person said, no, real fast. They really harbor on apparently the moment of just how quick Soifan is, and shows just how her abilities have really progressed in general. And it seems to me that she's just not playing around at all. Like, she's coming there speed blitzing and then goes into Shunko. Then we get switched over to Toshiro, which apparently then gets bodied, which is as you expected it to go. And then, of course, Kisuke calls and Mayuri isn't happy. And then we get Ichigo walking through the hallway and stumbling. And this is how that episode is going to be ending, with Ichigo running through that hallway. Now, of course, some of you are going to be like, well, what's this hallway that we're talking about? And this is the added scene. Not the scenes that you actually see within the PV. Of course, you see a scene of, like, Ichigo's his back, right? And that's probably in episode 14. Now, apparently, Ichigo's is training with Ichibei or whatever. He's the shrine that we see in like the PV. Let me just tell you the note that I have. It says that Ichigo has to walk half naked through a long pathway. Now, the context in regards to this here is that I imagine this is where Ichibei has told Ichigo, you can't go to the Soul Society, you can't beat Yuha, you have to go find yourself or whatever, right? You have to go do the training, X, Y, and Z. Now, taking off his clothes to be half naked, don't know why, but I'm pretty sure a lot of fangirls will love that. But apparently he's got to go to, and again, I might be wrong here, like the King's or the Soul King's like training grounds, right? He's going to like a place where it's specifically for the Soul King's training. Apparently he's got to walk this long path, just like I guess he would like through the Garganta, or like how Goku would go through Snake Way, right? But the thing is, what's great about this journey on this road path towards this, I guess, shrine, considering what we saw in the PV, is that each time he's going through, he's stumbling, because the further he walks, the heavier it's on him. Now, of course, this could be spiritual energy that's really weighing down on him, and this is why I'd probably compare it to when Vegeta or Goku are doing gravity training, so to say. It would seem that as Ichigo's going, the toughness level before you even get there to show maybe if you're even worthy enough is really taking a toll on Ichigo. And we know how strong Ichigo is. Like, he's got his dual blades now. He is strong as fuck. And he is running through this hallway or this pathway to get to this training arena. And, like, he's stumbling. Like, this is weighing really heavy on him. So it just goes to give you a sense of, like, Ichigo is nowhere near on a level of maybe what Soul King even is, right? Which would make sense, right? Of course, it's not that level. But regardless of what, the fact that he's as strong as he is and he's stumbling and not being able to take this energy is pretty interesting nonetheless. So again, I don't know why the clothing thing, but again, I'm really excited to see those little added extra scenes. Now again, I don't know which episodes it's in, that's why I put it as like an additional post, but it seems like we're going to get some really interesting new scenes. Of course, the one with Ichigo that we just spoke about, the one with Uryu and his contemplation within the grave, whatever that means, and the one of like Omida saving his sister, which is going to be really nice and sweet. What I see on Twitter time and time again is people from the audience that saw these two episodes and said movie quality. Now, movie quality gets thrown around quite a lot to the point where it pisses off quite a lot of people, especially if like you're hard on animation and you stalk like animators and shit like that, right? When you have so many people elaborating movie quality, it's got to have something special. And this was one of the questions I did ask, and it does apparently look really beautiful. Like, it's better than like the first episode or the second episode of Thousand Year Blood War on how they look. Like, the expectation was pretty high from episode one, right? So to really up the ante on that is really making me excited to see, what are people talking about? What are they seeing? And that's the anticipation. I heard some great stuff about like Toshiro versus Basby. Like, it's no episode 6 or 7 level, but it's pretty high. And that's quite exciting to see as well. And again, the really emphasis on Soifan speed is something that I'm very interested in too. So that's what I'm going to say for this episode in particular about, you know, the leaks of these two. I don't really want to harbour too much more on them. I can't wait to see basically these episodes, and I can't wait to live react to them. I can't wait to see what people are talking about and just the added scenes. And apparently as well, next core, for core 3, we're going to have some extra Ukitake scenes, which is fantastic because Ukitake for the longest time was like one of the only captains we barely see do anything except for cough, bleed, and get stabbed. So, and we know he's goaded. We know he's like raw as fuck. So I'm so happy. Like, this guy never has a fight. When he does have a fight, he's like shown to look cool and then just doesn't do anything. And then we just see him like injured, right? So I can't wait to see Ukitake actually do something, because we know he does bits. We have seen little smidgens of man doing bits. So core 3 sounds like exciting already, but we haven't got rid of core 2 yet, and we've got a lot to be excited about. So tell me what you guys think in the comment section down below of what you think of these two episodes and the additional scenes I've given you. All of these scenes that I've said aren't even all of them. I probably missed quite a bit as well. That's the thing. So enjoy. Gonna catch you guys later. You guys, of course, have this fine day. Be enhanced and hit that subscribe, and as always, people, peace out.